Following up from last year's 400 PS Golf GTI Heartbeat concept for Wörthersee, this year's hot hatch concept born from a student project also breaches the 400 PS mark with a 410 PS GTI First Decade concept, this time with an electrified boost. This latest Wörthersee-bound concept packs an internal combustion engine for the front axle, while a 48-volt electric motor sends 12 kilowatts of output to the rear wheels. The most prominent aspect of the First Decade concept is, of course, its aesthetics. Atlantic blue metallic paint features on the three-door car here, along with a satin ocean shimmer finish with blue chrome foil. The concept car rolls on unique 20-inch wheels, and also receives a rear spoiler from the Golf GTI Club Sport. The GTI First Decade receives a makeover on the inside as well, where the rear seats have been removed and in their place are new speakers for the audio system, along with what appears to be a full-size spare wheel. The audio setup comprises 11 speakers plus a subwoofer receiving 1,690 W of power, while the special installation also includes LED lighting on a carbon-covered base plate. The traction battery and drive electronics are housed beneath the base plate. Up in front, the pair of sports seats are trimmed in titanium black Nappa leather and Alcantara, with blue stitching. The driver's seat features electrical adjustment, which can be controlled on a smartphone or tablet via an app. Latest featured stories. Toyota CHR officially previewed in Malaysia. Honda Jazz facelift open for booking, petrol, hybrid. Driven, VW Tiguan 1.4 TSI, the middle ground. New Hyundai Elantra Sport Tiguan Turbo in Malaysia. Driven, BMW 740 LX Drive plug-in hybrid. G30 BMW 5 Series launched, 530i, RM399K. Search for your dream car on our car classifieds. More search options. Latest stories. Volkswagen Vento All-Star and GT Editions launched, from RM78,888, added kit at a lower price. In cars, local car launches, local news, Volkswagen, by Danny Tan, May 24, 2017 1:09 PM, zero comment. We've seen the Volkswagen Polo All-Star, now hear its sedan sister, the Volkswagen Vento All-Star. The dressed-up special edition of the B-segment sedan was launched today by Volkswagen Passenger Cars Malaysia, VPCM, at Midvalley and will be on display here from today till Sunday, May 28. Like the Polo All-Star, the Vento All-Star wears subtle accessories, which include black trim strips on the doors, a black boot garnish and an All-Star B-pillar badging. Inside, one will find leather seats, All-Star printed on the front seats, and aluminium sports pedals, plus floor mats and dorsal scuff plates with the All-Star script. The head unit is an RCD330G touchscreen infotainment system as found in the Polo All-Star. The Vento All-Star is based on the Comfort line, which means you get a 1.6-liter MPI naturally aspirated engine with 105 PS and 153 Newton-meters of torque at 3,800 revolutions per minute, mated to 6-speed conventional automatic transmission. It's available in reflex silver or candy white. Standard Comfort line kit include fog lamps, 15-inch riverside alloys, a height-adjustable front armrest, chrome interior highlights, leather-wrapped steering wheel and gear knob, climatronic auto aircon, cruise control, Bluetooth, 4 airbags and a 350G radio, CD player. VPCM says that the extra accessories are worth RM7,000, and the Vento All-Star is priced at ₹78,888, which includes discounts. The Comfort line's original price tag was ₹86,888, or ₹87,646 OTR excluding insurance, so it's more kit and a lower price. As a bonus, the Vento All-Star comes with the new MyVW Drive app, which shows the driver fuel consumption and driving style tracking, among other car data such as its location. Users can also use it to call for roadside assistance in emergencies. There's a SIM card in the car that communicates with the smartphone app. Subscription is free for 3 years. Volkswagen_Vento_G.T. 9. Volkswagen_Vento_All-Star 9. Volkswagen_Vento_G.T. 11. Volkswagen_Vento_All-Star 10. The Vento GT meanwhile is a special edition based on the top Vento High line, which is powered by a 1.2-liter TSI engine with 105 PS and 175 Nm from 1,550 to 4,100 revolutions per minute. The turbo motor is mated to a 7-speed DSG dual-clutch transmission. The GT is an attempt to inject some sportiness into the Vento, launched here a year ago, and it features a body kit that includes a front chin, side skirts, slim boot spoiler and a rear bumper extension that incorporates a black diffuser section. There's also a 3M satin black roof, black wing mirror caps and the lower door black strip that's also present on the All-Star. There's a GT badge on the boot. Also like the All-Star, the Vento GT is available in reflex silver or candy white and gets floor mats and door sill plates with GT script. There are also aluminium sports pedals and leather seats. The latter has GT printed on the front chairs, and you'll find a honeycomb-like pattern on the leather covers. The Highline that the GT is based on comes with all the kit on the Comfort line, but had 16-inch cyanet alloys with a two-tone machined finish and escape. The Vento GT, with additional kit worth ₹9,000, is priced at ₹89,888 inclusive of discounts. The Vento Highline's original list price was ₹93,888, or ₹94,461 OTR excluding insurance. We not only want to make our cars more accessible to Malaysians, but we also want to give them more options with value-added benefits, whilst ensuring that the cars they drive are instant head-turners, said Eric Winter, MD of VPCM. If you've been keeping track, you might be wondering where's the LED headlamps and daytime running lights from the updated Vento that appeared on Volkswagen's Malaysian website yesterday. Well, that's the update, and these are the run-off special editions. The car with the new eyes is not at mid-volley. Gallery, Volkswagen Vento All-Star. Gallery, Volkswagen Vento GT. Zero comments, leave a comment. Baru, article Turkini dalam Bahasa Malaysia. 2405 Tesla Model 3, model mampu milik yang mempunyai jarak 346 km, 0 to 96 km/j dalam 5.6 sat. 2405 Gili Bakal Menggambalala Kepentingan Terbesar Lotus, Peganan Sahamantara 50 hingga 75%. 2405 Gili Bersetuju Menjadi Rekan Kongsi Strategic Proton, Bakal Pegang Sebanyak 49% Kepentingan, Sumber. 2305 Proton Teramologi RM 1.7 billion dari Pada Karajan. 2305 Kia Optima GT Untuk Mejia, RM 180k dengan 242 horsepower. 2305 Kia Atasi Jualan Hyundai di Korea Buat Pertama Kali Pada 2016, Dijangka Untuk Sementara Waktu, Laporan. 2305 Fiat 500 liters MPV Diberi Facelift, Rupa, Teknologi Baharu. 2305 Prasaranis Azar Peningkatan Pengunapenggangkat Nawam Sabanyak 40% Menjelangda on 2030. 2305 Karajan Thailand Arakan Sarakat Insurance Untuk Beri Diskon 10% Bagi Karta Yangdung Kopi Dash Cam. 2305 MRT Pembinaan Lalu Lintas G. Balasar Dang Putra Jaya Dijangka Saya Pantara 15-18% Menjelang Akhir 2017. 2305 Peugeot Traveler Sekali Lagi Dikasan Menjelang Pelankranya di Malaysia Pada Saku Ketiga Tahun Ini. 2305 Video Kepentingan Pengunggurusi Keselamatan Kanak-kanak Dalam Kendaraan Dibawakan oleh Proton. 2305 Isuzu Buka Pusat Service Serbelengkap di Shah Alam. 2305 SUV Segmen C Hyundai Tucson Versi Lebih Lirakan Dihasilkan oleh Siap Berprestasi Tinggi Divisi N. 2305 KG and Demographic Pembikan Pulton.org, Jemputan Untuk Para Pembaka, Berita Kami Tentang Anda. 2017 Kawasaki Versys X250 gets prototype Givi boxes. In bike parts and accessories, bikes, Kawasaki, local bike news, by Moen K. Ramanajam, May 24, 2017 12:01 PM, zero comment. As a dual-purpose tourer in the quarter-liter class, the 2017 Kawasaki Versys X250 is designed to be a lightweight commuting, touring machine. However, pressing the Versys X to such duties requires storage space, something motorcycles are notoriously short of. When the baby Versys was launched, press photographs showed a version which came equipped with Kawasaki top box and panniers. However, during the Versys X media ride, we were informed that Kawasaki Motors Malaysia would not be bringing in the OEM luggage version, even as an option, as it would make the price prohibitive. There is a solution though, for riders wanting to extend the versatility of the RM23789 Versys X250, as Givi Malaysia has produced prototype brackets that will allow for the installation of a top box and panniers from Givi's range of motorcycle luggage. Pulton.org was invited by Givi to its production facility in Ruang, Selangor, to view the prototype and forward our opinion. 2017 Kawasaki Versys X250 Givi -5. 2017 Kawasaki Versys X250 Givi -8. 2017 Kawasaki Versys X250 Givi -10. As is typical of Givi brackets, the assembly is made from welded steel tubes, with a mounting plate for the top box. The bracket is designed to accommodate a variety of luggage types, including the Derija aluminium cases favored by overlander riding bikers. The prototype we viewed came equipped with a Givi B37 and top box and D22 panniers, and we were informed an aluminium bracket is being constructed for the X250. Pricing for the 2017 Kawasaki Versys X250 Givi bracket is currently under discussion, but is estimated to be RM150 for the top box and RM200 for the panniers, with the B37 and top box and E22 panniers sold at RM609 and RM450, bare, respectively. Zero comments, leave a comment. Volkswagen goes to Wörthersee 2017 with hybrid drive, Golf GTI First Decade, Golf GTE Estate Impulse. In cars, international news, Volkswagen, by Mick Chan, May 24, 2017, 11:58 a.m., zero comment. Following up from last year's 400 PS Golf GTI Heartbeat concept for Wörthersee, this year's hot hatch concept born from a student project also breaches the 400 PS mark with a 410 PS GTI First Decade concept, this time with an electrified boost. This latest Wörthersee-bound concept packs an internal combustion engine for the front axle, while a 48-volt electric motor sends 12 kilowatts of output to the rear wheels. The most prominent aspect of the First Decade concept is, of course, its aesthetics. Atlantic blue metallic paint features on the three-door car here, along with a satin ocean shimmer finish with blue chrome foil. The concept car rolls on unique 20-inch wheels, and also receives a rear spoiler from the Golf GTI Club Sport. The GTI First Decade receives a makeover on the inside as well, where the rear seats have been removed and in their place are new speakers for the audio system, along with what appears to be a full-size spare wheel. The audio setup comprises 11 speakers plus a subwoofer receiving 1,690 W of power, while the special installation also includes LED lighting on a carbon-covered base plate. The traction battery and drive electronics are housed beneath the base plate. Up in front, the pair of sports seats are trimmed in titanium black Nappa leather and Alcantara, with blue stitching. The driver's seat features electrical adjustment, which can be controlled on a smartphone or tablet via an app. This time around, Volkswagen has brought out not one, but two concepts. The second one here is the Golf GTE State Impulse from Zwickau. As suggested, this concept is based upon the Golf variant Estate model, and like the GTI-based concept above, the GTE Estate also features a hybrid powertrain. The GTE Estate concept packs a prototype battery with a capacity of 16.8 kWh, up from the standard item's 8.8 kWh, a development which Volkswagen says doubles the car's range in electric operation. Naturally, as a show car, the GTE Estate's looks has been given a once-over, inside and out. Its exterior gains 5-tone matte paintwork in Oryx White, Appassionata Blue, Anthracite, Hallmark, and St. James Red, while the bonnet receives ventilation slats. Inside, decorative trim is painted while the steering wheel, central console, selector gator and door trim feature blue decorative stitching. As with the GTI First Decade, the GTE Estate Impulse gains mobile app-controlled functions, here specifically for the animated, ambient lighting in the door trim. Additionally, the panoramic sliding roof, leather and Alcantara customized bucket seats with blue stitching, and Impulse logo top off the interior design elements. For more updates, subscribe MotoGuru.